In this problem, we want to develop the equations to determine the plug flow reactor size for 50% conversion of reactant A, where the reaction is A plus 2B goes to 2D. So I'm getting information about the pressure and the temperature, the rate of reaction, and how it depends on concentrations, mole fractions, and a volumetric flow rate. And so there's an inert also in the feed. And so what we want to do is write down the mole balances, and the change in the molar flow rate of A with respect to cumulative volume, so FA is moles per minute in this case, is the rate of reaction, where the rate of reaction is minus 2.5. The minus sign is very important here because A is reacting away and depends on the concentrations of A and B. So a similar equation in terms of the molar flow rate of B, the rate of reaction of B is twice the rate of reaction of A from the stoichiometry. And then the product, the mole balance for D, and this is minus 2 times R sub A. So the total term is positive. We're forming D. We need initial conditions, and that means at V equals 0, we need the molar flow rate of A. It's the mole fraction of A entering times the total flow rate entering, and this mole fraction 0.20. Well, the molar flow rate of B initially, again, mole fraction of B times the total molar flow rate, and this is 0.50. The molar flow rate of D is 0 initially. We're solving for the final volume, and we're going to have to calculate the total molar flow rate entering. So that's the volumetric flow rate entering times the total concentration entering. Given the total concentration or gas phase system is the pressure over the gas constant divided by absolute temperature. Think of the ideal gas law. You could write it as pressure times volume per time, which is V0, is moles per time, so that's FT0 over RT. So just ideal gas law. And we're given that V0 is 50 liters per minute. Now, to make these equations complete, in order to be able to solve them, we need the concentration of A and the concentration of B. Well, the concentration of A, can write as the molar flow rate of A over the volumetric flow rate. So what's important to keep in mind here is that the volumetric flow rate changes for this system because we have, go back and look at our reaction, we have 3 moles reacting to 2 moles. So our volumetric flow rate is going to change. Well, we need the concentration of B, and that means we need an equation for the volumetric flow rate, and it changes because the molar flow rate changes. So again, this is the ideal gas law. Well, now we have another variable. F total is the total molar flow rate, and total molar flow rate is what's changing. And that's the flow rate of A at any point in the reactor plus the flow rate of B, a molar flow rate, plus the flow rate of our product D plus the flow rate of our inert. Now, the flow rate of the inert is the mole fraction of the inert initially times the total molar flow rate, and that's 0.3 times the total molar flow rate. And this is the same as the inert flow at the inlet. The inert flow rate's not going to change. The final calculation that we need to do is to calculate the conversion, because we're going to carry out this integration until the conversion is 50%. And so the molar flow rate of A at the inlet minus the molar flow rate any point in the reactor divided by the molar flow rate of the inlet, this would be our fractional conversion, and we want at the exit, if we like, the final value to be 0.50. So we need to integrate, and what we're going to do is solve these three ordinary differential equations along with these algebraic equations simultaneously to determine the size of the reactor to give us 50% conversion.